When college football gets underway this year, you will likely see more of the players off the field than in years past. The name, image, and likeness rules went into effect in July, allowing student athletes to make money with endorsements. John Lewis talked with some of the players who have signed deals and with the people who deal with the players.
University of Louisville senior linebacker C.J. Avery has let his play do the talking. But now he is allowed to speak for himself off the field and for money.
Just ordered the new Bo's chicken sandwich from Bojangles. It's amazing. Make sure you come by and get it.
When the name, image, and likeness rules kicked in, many athletes started signing deals immediately to cash in.
You know, I knew when this NIL stuff started getting talked about that this could be a space that we could potentially help some of these kids.
Joey Wagner has spent 2 decades in marketing. He recently created Rocketeer Sports, an arm of his marketing company dedicated to representing collegiate athletes for NIL deals.
Our job is to act as more of like a manager to help them be successful and set them up for success. And that's the type of people we've built around on our team to put these athletes and kind of treat them like a professional athlete while they're in college. Because when they go pro, they're going to have to build that team around them that keeps them from going broke or making mistakes or not doing the right thing.
One of his clients is Avery, who is trying to dispel the notion that a lot of players will focus more on trying to sign deals than play the game.
To be honest, I haven't paid too much attention to the NIL because the thing with me, I'm thinking just keep the main thing the main thing. If you're balling out on the football field, everything else will fall in line for you on that.
I'm 100% behind the players in the right context.
Bellarmine head coach Scott Davenport shares that sentiment with a lot of coaches. Many worry about a snowball effect, like the reports that Alabama quarterback Bryce Young, who has yet to start a game for the Crimson Tide, had at least $600,000 in name, image, and likeness deals already signed.
What my biggest concern is if these numbers become astronomical, you mentioned $600,000 to $1 million on an 18-year-old. What happens to a rising senior in high school who maybe commits during his junior year in high school? And now, does he afford these opportunities? I'm just worried there's a lot more questions right now than there are answers.
A scenario close to that has already played out with Ohio State.
Zone, caught, touchdown, again.
Quinn Ewers, a Texas high school senior, was the number one prospect from the state, but reclassified and graduated early so he could sign an NIL deal.
What's up, guys? I'm excited to sign with Holy Beverages and Hope Squads.
In Texas, Ewers was unable to profit from his name, image, and likeness. But now that he's enrolled at Ohio State, the quarterback is allowed to make money from endorsements. While many companies like these are on the up and up, Wagner wants to make sure his clients are signing with companies who are aligned with the school's values and won't take advantage of the athletes.
More of these kids, like, you know, not knowing who they're working with and not knowing enough about the brands and not knowing enough about some of these people that are trying to help them, because there are going to be a lot of companies and brands and people that are going to try to take advantage of these kids, right? Because they're not business savvy and they really don't know how to do certain things. So that's kind of why we're here, to help them guide through that process.
NIL is a bit of a wild west right now, as the rules are ever evolving. And as we see deals from small appearance fees to possibly national exposure and ads, there's a really good chance you could see more and more players get on board throughout the season. John Lewis, WDRB Sports.